गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन एल्डिहाइड्स, कीटोन्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स, सो फार वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन, क्लासिफिकेशन, फर्दर द नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स. द नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स इज स्टडीड टुगेदर बिकॉज द नेम्स ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स आर बेस्ड ऑन ईच अदर, दे आर रिलेटेड विथ ईच अदर. दैट्स वाई we have studied the nomenclature of carboxylic acids and aldehydes together. Now the next is the nomenclature of ketones. Today we are going to study the nomenclature of ketones. The nomenclature of ketones is possible by two methods, the trivial or common method, common system, and other is the IUPAC system. Now in common system, the names are based on the names of two alkyl groups or aryl groups which are attached to the keto group, that is the carbonyl carbon. You know that in the ketones the functional group is C double bond O. This is the functional group of ketones. This is the functional group in ketones, and here two alkyl groups or aryl groups are attached to this keto group. These are alkyl groups or aryl groups. Or there may be one alkyl group and one aryl group. All of these are the general formulae of the ketones. And here the common names are based on the names of these alkyl groups or these aryl groups which are present in the ketone. Here to write the trivial name or common name of the ketone, the names of these alkyl groups or the aryl groups should be written first in alphabetical order, followed by the word ketone. How to obtain the common name? Write the names of these two alkyl groups or two aryl groups or one aryl group and one alkyl group in alphabetical order followed by the word ketone. This is the procedure to obtain the trivial name or common name. In case of substituted ketone. Here you can see this is the substituted ketone. Br is the substituent. Now the position of the substituent is indicated by the Greek letters such as alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Position of the substituent in the ketone is indicated by the Greek letter alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Here the carbon atom which is attached directly to the keto group, that carbon is numbered as alpha carbon. The carbon adjacent to the keto group, that is alpha carbon, next carbon is the beta carbon, next carbon is the gamma carbon. On the second side also, the carbon which is attached to the keto group is the alpha carbon, other carbon, next carbon is the beta carbon. So here the position of the substituent, that is the Br, is alpha. So if there is a presence of any substituent in the ketone, then the position of that substituent is indicated by the Greek letters in trivial system or common system. Here this Br is present at alpha position. Here the Br is present at alpha position. In this way, by the Greek letter, the position of the substituent is indicated. Then further, the names of aromatic ketones are based on the suffix phenone. In the names of the aromatic ketones, there is a use of suffix phenone. Phenone is the suffix which is utilized to obtain the names of aromatic ketones. This is the systematic method to obtain the trivial or common names of the ketones. Second system is the IUPAC system. In the IUPAC system, first of all, in the given ketone, the longest carbon chain is selected. The longest carbon chain including the keto group. This is the keto group. The longest carbon chain must include the keto group. So, longest carbon chain including the keto group is selected first of all. Here, this will be the longest carbon chain including the keto group. Ketonic carbon, it contains 6 carbon atoms, and therefore, the parent alkane of this ketone will be, first of all, decide the parent alkane. The parent alkane is decided from the number of carbon atoms in the longest chain. Here the parent alkane will be hexane, because in this ketone there are 6 carbon atoms in the longest chain. So this is the very important step in the IUPAC nomenclature of ketones. First of all, select the longest chain. But care should be taken that in that longest chain, the carbon atom of the keto group must be included. After selecting the longest chain, count the number of carbon atoms in that longest chain. And from the numbering of carbon atoms, decide the parent alkane. Here 6 carbon atoms are there in the longest chain, therefore its parent alkane is hexane. Then, number the carbon atoms in the longest chain. How to number the carbon atoms? The carbon atoms are numbered in such way that are from that end which is closer to the keto group. Now here this is the end which is closer to the keto group. This keto group is closer from this end, and therefore the numbering is started from this end. Keto group is away from this end, but it is closer from this end, and therefore the numbering is started from this end. So this is the correct numbering. After the numbering you can write the IUPAC name. To write the IUPAC name, see here the sequence. First of all, if there is a presence of any branch or substituent, if there is a presence of any branch or substituent, then first of all write the position of the branch, 5U, name of the branch, methyl, this is methyl, then write the name of the parent alkane. Here the name of the parent alkane is hexane. But from hexane, replace the ending E, remove the ending E by another suffix, O-N-E. Another suffix, O-N-E. So here, new suffix is added. But before adding that new suffix, write the position of the keto group. That is the number which is given to the keto group. Here the keto group has third position. It is present at third position, and therefore 3, and the new suffix is O-N-E. So its IUPAC name become 5-methyl-hexane-3-O-N-E. 5-methyl-hexane-3-O-N-E. Means in general, from the given parent alkane, the ending E is replaced by another suffix O-N-E, and therefore the ketones are named as corresponding alkanones. Alkanone is the general name of IUPAC name of ketone. Any ketone is named in this way, by replacing the ending E from the name of the parent alkane and by adding the new suffix O-N-E. But care should be taken that here before writing the suffix O-N-E, the position of the keto group should be entered. Now if a ketone contain, if a compound contain two keto groups are there. Here two keto groups are there. Then after selecting the longest chain and after giving the numbers, the IUPAC name is obtained, but here the ending E from the name of the parent alkane is not replaced. It is retained. Here the parent alkane will be pentane, and the ending E in the name of the parent alkane is retained. Because here two keto groups are present. Two keto groups are present in the same compound. Therefore the ending E is retained. After that the positions of the keto group are written. First keto group at the second position. Second keto group at the third position. And here the new suffix is added. That new suffix is di-O-N-E. That is a dione. So IUPAC name of this ketone become pentane-2,3-dione. So care should be taken here that the ending E from the name of the parent alkane is replaced only when there is a presence of single keto group. But if there are two keto groups in the same compound, in the same molecule, then the ending E in the name of the parent alkane should be retained. It is not replaced. And the new suffix is added there, that is a dione. So pentane-2,3-dione, this is the IUPAC name of this ketone. Then, in case of allocyclic ketones, the keto group is always numbered as कार्बन नंबर वन, दिस इज अ कीटोनिक कार्बन इज नंबर्ड एज नंबर वन, कीटोनिक कार्बन इज नंबर्ड एज फर्स्ट कार्बन एंड द अदर कार्बन एटम्स आर नंबर्ड फ्रॉम दैट कार्बन 1, 2, 3, 4 इन दिस वे. सो इन एलिसाइक्लिक कीटोन्स, एलिसाइक्लिक कीटोन्स मीन्स दोज कीटोन्स हुज पैरेंट हाइड्रोकार्बन इज अ एलिसाइक्लिक हाइड्रोकार्बन, दैट इज द साइक्लोप्रोपेन, साइक्लोब्यूटेन, साइक्लोपेंटेन, साइक्लोहेक्सेन. This is the cyclopropane, this is the cyclobutane, this is the cyclopentane, this is the cyclohexane. These are the alicyclic compounds. And when any alicyclic compound is the parent hydrocarbon of the ketone, in such a ketone, the carbon atom of the keto group is numbered as first carbon. The numbering is started from the ketonic carbon. So here the numbering is started from this ketonic carbon. Here are the IUPAC name of this ketone will be, these are the branches at the position number 3 and 4, 3rd, 3, 4, name of the branches are methyl, therefore dimethyl. Names of both the branches are similar, therefore dimethyl is written here, 3, 4 dimethyl. The parent hydrocarbon is cyclohexane, cyclohexane, from the name of the cyclohexane, the ending E is replaced by ONE. Here the numbering indicating the position of the keto group is not required because here the keto group is always at position number 1. It is always at position number 1. Therefore, the position of the keto group is not necessary here. So, 3,4-dimethyl cyclohexanone. This will be the IUPAC name. In case of polyfunctional ketones, polyfunctional ketones. Polyfunctional ketones means such a ketone in which there is the presence of keto group as well as any other functional group such as aldehyde group or carboxylic group or any other functional group is there. So in polyfunctional ketone, if the keto group is a secondary functional group, if the keto group is not primary, if the keto group doesn't get the higher priority, if the keto group gets the lower priority, then for that keto group, there is a use of prefix, oxo. Prefix, oxo is used for naming the keto group in case of such a ketone. A ketone, polyfunctional ketone, in which the keto group is a secondary functional group, that is the keto group is a functional group of lower priority, then for such a keto group of lower priority, there is the use of prefix oxo. For example, here, now in this compound, it is a polyfunctional compound, polyfunctional ketone, there is a keto group as well as aldehyde group. Now, in the priority order, we have seen that aldehyde group gets the higher priority than the keto group. Aldehyde group gets the higher priority than keto group. Means keto group is not a principal group. It gets the lower priority. It is a group of lower priority. Therefore, here its name is written in the form of prefix. And here, for this keto group, the prefix is oxo. Oxo. Here the longest chain contains 4 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Therefore, the parent alkene is butane. The name of the secondary group, that is the group of lower priority, is oxo, and the position of the keto group is 3, therefore 3 oxo, parent alkene is butane. Here the principal group is aldehyde group, and for the aldehyde group, the ending E is replaced by Al. So its IUPAC name become 3-oxobutanol. 3-oxobutanol will be the IUPAC name. Here the aldehyde group is the functional group of higher priority than the keto group. So by using these rules, let us see some examples of ketones, their common and IUPAC names. Example, common name and IUPAC name. CH3 is C double bond O CH3. The common name or trivial name is dimethyl ketone. Dimethyl ketone. More popularly, it is known as acetone. Remember, acetone. Dimethyl ketone is the common name, no doubt. But more popularly, it is known as acetone. Now, what will be its IUPAC name? In this ketone, there are three carbon atoms only in the longest chain. Longest chain contains three carbon atoms only. Therefore, its parent alkene will be propane. And therefore, from propane, the ending E is replaced by the suffix ONE. Therefore, its IUPAC name become propanone. Now, here the position of the keto group is not necessary. Position of the keto group is not necessary because the keto group will be certainly at position number 2. There will be no other possibility. There is no other possibility. Always here the keto group will be at position number 2. And therefore, before writing the new suffix ONE, the position of the keto group is not necessary here. Then the next example, CH3, C11O, CH2, CH3. In this ketone, the two alkyl groups are dissimilar. Therefore, the trivial name will be obtained by writing the names of these two alkyl groups in the alphabetical order. Ethyl is written first, then methyl, and then ketone. So, trivial name become ethyl methyl ketone. Now, what will be its IUPAC name? The longest chain contained 4 carbon atoms. Therefore, the parent alkene is butane. From the name of the butane, the ending E is replaced by ONE. E is replaced by ONE. Again here, the position of the keto group is not compulsory, not necessary, because here also, the keto group will certainly have the position number 2. Keto group cannot be present at any other position. It will be always at position number 2, and therefore, no need to write the butane 2 ONE. You can write only butanone. Then, CH3, CH2, C11O, CH2, CH3. Here two alkyl groups are there which are similar. The names of the alkyl groups are ethyl. Therefore, its common name will be diethyl ketone. Diethyl ketone is the common name. And IUPAC name now. Longest chain contain 5 carbon atoms. The keto group is at the position number 3. So, from the name of the parent alkene will be pentane. The ending E is replaced by ONE. But before writing the suffix ONE, the position of the keto group should be entered. Here the position of the keto group is 3. And therefore, pentane 3, ONE. See here. CH3, C11O, CH2, CH2, CH3. Here also, the longest chain contain 5 carbon atoms. Its parent alkene is also pentane. Now the common name. Common name will be methyl. Alphabetically, M is written first. Methyl is written first. Methyl N propyl. Ketone. Methyl N propyl ketone is the common name. Now what will be the IUPAC name? Longest chain contain 5 carbon atoms. Therefore the parent alkene is pentane. But the keto group is situated at a position number 2. Therefore, the IUPAC name will be pentane 2 ONE. Pentane 2 ONE. Then CH3, CH2, C double bond O, CH, BR, CH2, CH3. In this ketone, there is a presence of substituent Br at position number alpha. This is also alpha, this is beta, this is gamma. But on this side, there are no substituent. On this side, there is a presence of substituent, bromine, at the alpha position. Now, the names of these two alkyl groups are ethyl and N propyl. But in this ethyl group, at the alpha position, there is a presence of Br. Therefore, alpha bromo ethyl, alpha bromo ethyl, and the name of the other group is N propyl, alpha bromo ethyl N propyl ketone, alpha bromo ethyl N propyl ketone. This is the trivial name of this ketone. This is the ethyl group, but in this ethyl group at the alpha position there is a presence of substituent bromine. Therefore, alpha bromoethyl N-propyl ketone. Now, what will be the IUPAC name? Longest chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbon atoms are there in the longest chain. 6 carbon atoms. The carbon atoms should be numbered from this end, left hand side, because the left hand side is closer to the keto group, or the keto group is closer from the left hand side. The keto group here get the position number 3. And the substituent Br get the position number 2. So first of all, write the position of the substituent, name of the substituent, 2-bromo. Then 6 carbon atoms are there in the longest chain, therefore the parent alkene is hexane. From the hexane, replace ending E by the another suffix ONE. But before writing ONE, add the position of the keto group, 3. Position of the keto group is 3. So 2-bromo-hexane-3-ONE. This is the IUPAC name of this ketone. 2-bromo-hexane-3-ONE. Let us see few more examples. Here the two alkyl groups are dissimilar. This is the methyl group, this is the isopropyl group. The names of the alpha alkyl group should be written in alphabetical order. Methyl, other group is isopropyl. So common name become methyl isopropyl ketone. Now what will be the IUPAC name? Longest chain contain 4 carbon atoms, but here at the third position there is a presence of branch methyl. Therefore, its IUPAC name will become 3-methyl. Parent alkene will be butane. Butane E is replaced by ONE, but the position of the keto group is 2, therefore 2-ONE. So, 3-methyl butane 2-ONE. This is the IUPAC name of this ketone. This is an unsaturated ketone. Unsaturated ketone. Its common name is mesityl oxide. Common name of this ketone is mesityl oxide. Now what will be its IUPAC name? Here two functional groups are present, carbon-carbon double bond and keto group. These are the two functional groups. But here this is the group of higher priority. Keto group is the group of higher priority. Therefore, in the numbering, during the numbering, the group of higher priority must get the lowest possible number. The group of highest priority should get the lowest possible number. The longest chain contains 5 carbon atoms, therefore the parent alkene is pentane. At the third position, there is the presence of carbon-carbon double bond. And at the fourth position, there is the presence of methyl group. At the second position, there is the keto group. So what will be its IUPAC name here? 4-methyl branch is present at the fourth position. 4-methyl longest chain contain 5 carbon atoms. Therefore, parent alkene is pentane. From the pentane, first of all, for the carbon-carbon double bond, the suffix ANE is replaced by another suffix ENE. So here, keto group is present at position number 3. Therefore, 3 pent 3 ENE. But now, from ENE, the ending E is replaced by ONE. Because now, there is a presence of keto group at the second position. And therefore, 2-ONE. So, its IUPAC name become 4-methyl-pent-3-in-2-ONE. 4-methyl-pent-3-in-2-ONE. What does it mean? There is a presence of methyl group at the fourth position, double bond at the third position, and the keto group at the second position. So IUPAC name of this ketone, unsaturated ketone, which is commonly known as mesityl oxide, is 4-methyl pent 3 into ONE. then aromatic ketone. The common name of this aromatic ketone is methyl phenyl ketone. Methyl phenyl. Because on one side there is a methyl group, on the other side there is a phenyl group. Therefore, methyl phenyl ketone. But more popularly it is known as acetophenone. 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 IUPAC name. Acetophenone is accepted as a IUPAC name. Though it is a trivial name, it is also accepted as a IUPAC name. Acetophenone. Its IUPAC name is acetophenone. Then, again, some examples. CH3 C double bond O, CH2 C double bond O, CH2 CH3. This is a diketone. It is a diketone. There is no any rule to write the common name for the diketone. You can write the IUPAC name. Longest chain contain 6 carbon atoms. Therefore, the parent alkene will be hexane. The keto group is situated at position number 2 and 4. Therefore, hexane. As it is a diketone, E is retained. E should be retained there. It is not replaced. Hexane, position of the keto group is 2 and 4. And new suffix is dione. So, hexane 2,4 dione. This is the IUPAC name of this ketone. Then, one more example of aromatic ketone. This is the aromatic ketone named as diphenyl ketone in common system. Diphenyl ketone, because both of these are the phenyl groups, but it is more popularly known as the benzophenone. Benzophenone. And this benzophenone is also accepted as the IUPAC name. Benzophenone is accepted as the IUPAC name also. Though it is a common name, it is also accepted as the IUPAC name. Then, let us see the example of alicyclic ketone. Alicyclic ketone. This is the alicyclic ketone. As already mentioned, as already explained, in alicyclic ketone, the carbon atom of the keto group is numbered as 1. So, here at the third position, there is the presence of chlorine. Common name is not written for this compound because there is no any rule to write the common name. So, 3-chloro, 4-methyl. Parent hydrocarbon is cyclohexane. From cyclohexane, ending E is replaced by ONE. So, IUPAC name of this ketone become 3-chloro-4-methyl-cyclohexanone. This is IUPAC name of this ketone. Now, I am taking some compounds with the bond line formula. You must be able to write the name. I am writing here the bond line formula. What should be the IUPAC name of this ketone? You should know the meaning of this compound. This terminal is nothing but methyl. This angle, this bent is nothing but methylene group. This is the CH, this is the CH3. This is the CH, this is the CH3. Later on, this is the C double bond O, this is the CH2. And last is the CH3. This bond line formula actually has this type of structure. So, what will be its IUPAC name? See here. Longest chain contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, here the keto group is present closer from this end and therefore the carbon atoms are numbered from the right side. The parent alkene will be heptane. Now, here there is a presence of methyl branches at position number 4 and 5. Therefore, 4, 5 dimethyl. 4,5 4,5-dimethyl parent alkene is heptane. Now from heptane, the ending E should be replaced by ONE. But the position of the keto group is here third, therefore 3-ONE. 4,5-dimethyl heptane, 3-ONE. This is the IUPAC name of this ketone.